Police say the victim in a brazen attack did the right thing by fighting back. And because of her actions, a suspect is in custody tonight. KMBC 9's Marcus Moore is live in Shawnee where it all happened. Marcus?
Jim, we are at the Gum Spring Park right along West 67th Street here in Shawnee. The bathroom behind me is where a lot of this went down this morning. A woman in her 20s was out for a walk when she was attacked by a suspect.
There is still crime tape at the scene of Friday morning's alleged attack in a quiet neighborhood park.
I wasn't sure about the police tape, and I thought, okay, since there's an officer that lives around here, I don't know. Maybe the kids were playing with it or something.
Only now is Diane Schwartz learning about what police say happened along the same trail where she walks a dog. A woman in her 20s was here around 8 Friday morning when police say a man armed with a knife attacked the woman and tried raping her near the bathrooms. But the victim fought back, which police say likely made the difference.
Let the attacker know that he was not going to have his way and she was not going to make it easy for him. It also bought her time.
Enough time, police say, for a passerby to see the woman struggle. The Good Samaritan went to help, and that is when the suspect took off in a car, but not before both the victim and the witness got his license plate number and gave it to police. They've now arrested 19-year-old Rufus McDonald, who authorities say lived near the park. The entire incident, though, is an eye-opener for people like Schwartz, who says women shouldn't walk alone.
I see a lot of it, even when it's starting to get dark. I just don't think it's a good idea anywhere you're at.
Police say the victim in this case was not seriously hurt. Meanwhile, the suspect, Rufus McDonald, is expected to face a number of charges, including aggravated assault, attempted kidnapping, and attempted rape. We're live in Shawnee tonight. I'm Marcus Moore, KMBC 9 News.
Marcus, thank you. McDonald is at the Johnson County Detention Center tonight. He is expected to be arraigned tomorrow.